confusing. There's no centralized standards of how everyone does it from one thing to another. You join one team, one project, you're doing it an entirely different way. And for a proper environment, cost of entry is a lot of times just out of your budget. You get, you know, you're doing your proof of concept, you're doing your initial billing, you can't afford a really expensive environment to get started, and you get started on the wrong foot, and now you're doing everything like through 15 different programs. Also, just generally these teams just have a lack of a team development platform altogether, and there's no real, you know, methodology that's just governing how it should be done. So we've aimed to fix these problems. And how we're going about fixing it is we're unifying the working environment for team collaboration. So everyone's in one space working together. And we're also using the most in-demand tools right now for data science and analytics, such as, you know, R, Python, and SQL. And we want to do it at an affordable rate for users or, you know, enterprise licensing. So getting your in-platform started becomes like your first thing. It's not a huge line item, and you're basically not throwing out your whole budget because you want a nice IDE environment where you can actually accomplish good work. And we do it with a shared workspace. We have a standardization of tools and processes, and we even offer training available from longtime experts in the field just so you can get the most out of your team and you get off to a good step. So what is on our platform? So our platform contains RStudio, JupyterHub, Shiny, Scilab, OwnCloud, and Commvault. So I'll start off with RStudio. So RStudio is the number one IDE environment for R, which is the number one language in data science and analytics right now. And what we've done was we've made sure to homogenize it with everything else on the system. This is our starting point, like with JupyterHub. JupyterHub is a Python development. It allows you to get the most out of your Python code, and because everyone uses R and uses Python analytics, that's the backbone. And by homogenizing the environment, you're working in the same script in the same place, and you can switch between the IDEs. Now, eventually, you're going to need to do a proof of concept or some visualization of your model. So we also completely support Shiny, and we even have every user has a Shiny folder where you can just drag and drop your project, and it's up and going, and you're good to go. No more installation. Just super easy, simple Shiny integration. Now, eventually, you have to deploy it somewhere, right? Your model sitting on your system, useless. So with Scilab, it gives you an API where you can interact with JSON objects and HTML tables to actually, you know, get some productive work out of your model. Again, we're all in the same infrastructure. So now OwnCloud. So what we like to do too is for security, you can keep everything on the same platform. OwnCloud is an open source Dropbox alternative, so we keep everything on the platform, easy to share, upload files, but you keep everything there on the centralized server, wherever it may be. And then we have Kanban, which is a project management tool. If you're familiar with Trello boards, just a nice way to control your workflow to optimize the project you're working on so you can get the most out of your time. Now, we're building this platform up. We're going to keep adding more stuff to it. And I can say coming very soon, we're going to have Spark and HTML integration. And then we're just going to keep adding on from there. Now, data management tool, you know, it's worthless without a database, right? So we have complete support for SQL, Postgres, Hadoop, and Data Lake. And we have SQL and Postgres installed, configured, and plugged right into RStudio and everything nice and ready for you from the very start, so you hit the ground running. Now, deployment. Our system right now, today, is deployable on Ubuntu 16.4, Ubuntu 16.10, and Debian 8. We are going to be supporting Fedora 19 and the newest Red Hat Enterprise 7 very soon, making it official. Supported environments for deployment right now: Microsoft Azure, Amazon Cloud, IBM Lumix, Rackspace, and we have our own cloud cluster that you can deploy in if you just want it up and running immediately, as well as we offer on-premise deployment. Now, if you already use LDAP or Active Directory, we can import your users directly into it so you guys can just go day one. And on any virtual machine deployment, we offer same day deployment. So you schedule with us, we're good, we get it running that day. Now, I'd like to open up for any questions because I covered a lot of ground, but we were trying to just show this quickly. So does anyone have any questions about the system, connectivity, shared space, or any features of it? Or any questions at all? So you build your model, but you're just basically interacting with a console, you know. So basically, how Shiny works is it's a graphical interface. have, it basically allows you to do visualizations of your model. So you can do all sorts of nice ways to package and show your data so people who are on your team, like whoever, you know, the higher ups can actually see that something's going on. They can see visualization, accurate representations of predictions and, you know, what your model's doing. And then Scilab just allows you to have an API access to the model. So you can have some other system make API calls and then pull things from your model, interact with it from some other server, some other system, wherever, you know, the data needs to be accessed, however it needs to intertwine with your model. Anybody else? Yeah.
Where are you guys just on, I haven't looked at the website or anything, customer, number of customers, customer base, employment, like, are you?
Sorry, so where are we at on what?
Yeah, repeat the question.
Yes. Yeah, the question was just where are you guys on, how many customers you guys have, and what the growth of the node, but I haven't looked at it all, so I've not seen it, so just kind of curious.
Well, right now on the platform, we're in beta testing.
Okay.
We're beta testing it with the people in the boot camp and the educational, but we're near ready for deployment in companies and official use. We're actually looking for beta test groups, like companies as well. So we're ready to get it out there and get it in use.
Like a private beta?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like the implementation would be an implementation on a secure server with a secure team working on it, not like open. Every implementation's in the video.
Anybody else?
Awesome. How many people would like to try to do something with R tonight? Anybody else? Okay. Okay, so let's see. Who did we give access to so far, those that sent their email address? Can you go over them so at least they know what to log in? Yeah, you do need a web access at least, right?
Yeah.
So does anybody have